da da da. Just think, when winter comes, can spring be far behind? Beneath the deepest snows, the secret of a rose is merely that it knows you must believe in spring. Just as a tree is sure its leaves will reappear, it knows its emptiness is just a time of year. The frozen mountain's dreams of April's melting streams. How crystal clear it seems, you must believe in spring. You must believe in love and trust it's on its way. Just as a sleeping rose awaits the kiss of May. So in a world of snow, of things that come and go, where what you think you know, you can't be certain of, you must believe in spring and love. So in a world of snow, of things that come and things that go, where what you think you know, you can't be certain of, you must believe in spring and love. Oh, you must believe in spring and love across the room. Some jump up in the morning to glimpse the sunrise. Some snap up the shade and let in the gloom. It's a big enough world and it takes all kinds, the good, the bad, and mostly in between. I love the people with the happy hearts. Oh, let your heart dance. There are years that ask big, big questions and years to try to answer them all. Your knees and your call. But old time and gravity can keep you way down if you let yourself forget how to fly. I need the people with the happy hearts. Oh, let your heart fly. Well, just take it all in, see where you've been, and let it all out again. Oh. want to be heard. You've had some love and it's sweet as a lemon taken slow, poison from the slippery word. No one has ever made the last mistake yet or bounced back one too many times. You owe yourself a dose of happy heart. Oh, let set your heart free now. Take it all in, see where you've been. Let it all out again. The only time you'll end up in a corner is by walking in too straight of a line. The only way you'll end up all alone is by refusing to give someone a sign. I'd rather feel all bad than just half good, though I'm no doubt before I'm through. Bring on the people with a happy heart, so let your heart sing. Put a fire to find the dead.
Welcome to the Wednesday Evening Musicale, everybody. We're in week four of requests, wonderful, thoughtful requests from people. And I'm going to back announce that first song, You Must Believe in Spring, which is written by Michelle Legrand, lyrics by Marilyn and Alan Bergman, that was requested by Cindy Spillers. It's such a beautiful song. I mean, it's a song about a season, but it's so metaphorical, so beautiful and timely. So, and then I went into Happy Hearts, which is a song of mine from a long time ago. And I'm doing that tonight, especially for Roger and Carol Faber in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Song I love, and in fact, I'd been hoping somebody would request it. I'm trying to stay true to requests. And then lo and behold, this list came from Roger and Carol, and that song was on it. So thank you for that. You made my wish come true. So nice to have you here tonight. I'm going to move on to a song that was requested by my friend in Chicago, Jay O'Reilly, longtime friend and fan. It's a song that was inspired by ambivalence, if you can say one is inspired by ambivalence. Actually, with all the polarity going on, ambivalence almost sounds refreshing, doesn't it, right now? But the thing is, what inspired this song is when you're the only thing worse than kind of feeling ambivalent, that kind of slippy, slidey around, is when you feel it coming back at you, especially in the regions of the heart. That's where this song came from. It's called Coming Clear.
Well, I've gone so far past halfway that I met my again for any lover or friend. So don't you go ask me to read your mind or serve up enough trust for two.
Coming clear. Well, speaking of clear, there is nothing so clear as the morning after a blizzard. And I was in Chicago. I was supposed to play on New Year's Eve when the what started as the blizzard of 1978 turned into the blizzard of 1979 because I couldn't get to my gig that night. I couldn't get back to my home in Green Bay. I was stranded in Wilmette, Illinois, at my friend's house, who had made it out on the last plane to St. Thomas before O'Hare shut down. And but not me. I was in the basement of my friend's house watching Fred Astaire and Ginger Roger movies and drinking amaretto for that whole night. So the next morning, of course, I get up and Chicago is completely shut down. Nothing going on. I walk outside gingerly. That sun is so bright, clear. And I take a step and I hear, and it's that snow after a blizzard in the cold, you know, the way it squeaks. And I take another step, and it's like, oh my God, you know, my head after all that amaretto. But I continue my walk and I go, and every now and then there would be another sound coming from the near distance, kind of going, which of course was somebody trying to hurdle their car out of a snow-packed parking place out into the street fruitlessly. And so what happened was I went into this kind of altered state between the and suddenly I had a hallucination above my head. It was a bubble, one of those great bubbles. And in the bubble was a driver that I sort of construe now as the kind of would-be driver of all those futile attempts I was hearing around the neighborhood. And so he's sitting at the steering wheel. Here's what I'm seeing. Sitting at the steering wheel, slumped over, having just given up the umpty-umpth try to get the car out of the parking place. And as he just sits there in a kind of passive state, a golden light suddenly washes down over only this car and this driver. And the driver becomes aware and is frightened. One part of him is frightened and says, oh, I should get out of here and I should run away. But the other part kind of sits there because he feels this light. And in the light, he feels humor. And in the light, he feels compassion. And in the light, he even feels humor. So while he's kind of enjoying this wash of light, The radio comes on of its own volition, and through the radio comes a celestial chorus singing the words exactly that this driver needs to hear at this point. And that's what led to the writing of the song. I just took notes, my friends. So I want you to not imagine the celestial chorus when we get to this point, but I want you to be the celestial chorus. And when you hear me sing, "Rock that sucker," I want you to answer back celestially, "Rock that sucker!" If your auto is stuck in snow, here's one thing that you should know: how to rock that sucker, rock that sucker, rock that sucker, rock that sucker, rock that sucker if you're gonna get home tonight. Now when you're in up to your shins, that is when the fun begins. It's when you rock that sucker, 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 and you move on down the road. You got to pull it up, back it up, pull it up, back it up, pull it up, back it up, rock that sucker, yeah, rock that sucker, rock that sucker if you really want to be free. Now if it's winter and you're dry, you got to know one thing just to survive: how to rock that sucker. Take it, rock that sucker. Pull it up, back it up, pull it up, back it up, rock that sucker, rock that sucker, rock that sucker if you really want to be. I mean, there are any number of things you can do at this point in time. I'll call them options. Option number one, get on out of that car and walk away down the street. Never look back at yourself, a bike, or walk everywhere else in your life. Never drive a car again, but let's face it, you probably aren't going to do that, are you? Mm-hmm. Option number two, call yourself a wrecker. Probably got a wrecker app on that new fancy phone of yours. Your wrecker truck will come right over and haul you out of that snow-packed parking place and cost you $89,011.27. What do you think they call them, wreckers? Listen. All you got to do is pull it up, give a little gas. Back it up, give a little gas. Pull it up, give a little gas. Back it up, give a little gas. Too much gas. Back it up, and you're gonna get home in time for that nice warm supper sitting there on the table for you tonight. Rock that sucker! Rock that sucker. That was for Kathy Fox, by the way, that song. And I'm sure many others of you were going, yeah, rock that sucker. It's hard to imagine things being brittle and rigid at this time of year. It's so humid right now. It's raining again outside. And you can sit out on the porch and almost see the tomatoes growing and the weeds growing and my hair growing. But it won't be that long before we're back in that time again. But going back even a little earlier into the spring, I was traveling with my friend Sally Rogers many years ago up in northern Michigan doing one of our Mother's Day concerts, and all the trillium, this was in May, were just exploding. And we were commenting on their beauty, and she used a term that she'd learned from her grandmother that I'd never heard before. She said, oh, yeah, they're beautiful, but they're going by. Or, oh, yeah, look at those. They've already gone by. And I went, what? She said, yeah, I learned that from my grandmother. And I just loved those words so much, going by. They just had a gravitas and a depth to them. And it sort of tucked them away the way I do with words. And this song came out not long afterward. It went in a whole different direction. And I'm doing this song for my friend Pam Luce in Charlevoix, Michigan. And I want to thank you, Pam and Robin, for going and checking in on my dad now and then, making sure he's okay. And hope to see you all again before too long. It's called Going By. These spring wildflowers, they pass so quickly. Their sudden glory, it will not wait. You cannot plan for their perfect moment. You must just be there or be too late. Here's the chorus. Going by, 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 going by. These children grow, they change so swiftly. They crawl one moment, the next they fly. The wings of time, so cruel and heartless, they steal your children with no goodbye. Here we go.
Going by, 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 going by.
Each word it passes into silence. Each thought it seeks is life in breath. Each breath it takes to ring the great wind song, the wind that carries us to our Pam Luce. I'm going to do a quick retune here while I'm reaching way, way back into my brain. There we go. So I grew up in this small town, and we had more than one what you call your town weirdo. We sort of had an embarrassment of town weirdos, I guess, and I thought that was just the norm. And then I went off into the world, and sure enough, each place I lived or spent time, there didn't seem to be quite the abundance, but there was always somebody who kind of fit that description of town weirdo. And so a few years into my musical career, I was still a baby performer, but I was thinking about that, and I thought of this song, which is kind of a composite of town weirdos I have known. I always seem to gravitate toward them in my younger days and my older days too. So this is a request from Ian Rudick and Carol Barney Stinson, and it's another one that I'm sure a lot of people are going, oh my god, I can't believe she's playing that song. So here's Fuzzy. Fuzzy grinned like his face bones was stuck that way all day and into the night. I bet he slept that way. He lived in our town, and small towns can be hard on someone who just can't help but feel big. His kids loved Fuzzy. We'd dance around him all day long and sing. Fuzzy Wuzzy was a bald-headed baby. We were rotten to him, but we didn't mean a thing. And he laughed just like he was one of us. Man, he was neat, but I guess there was something wrong with him. Didn't really matter. Told us stories, and they came out his eyes, and he taught us a song. We sang along. Let's see, it went something like, "You are magic, full of magic things. Magic, magic dances in the one who sings." That's it. You are magic for the magic things. Magic dances in the one who sings. Ah, we didn't really care much about the words. We'd mostly jump around and go la 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 la. Because our moms and dads said, "Leave that man alone." He had a dead spider collection. He'd let us see if we'd come to his home. And man, it was worth every licking we got to sneak off and be his friend. Oh, we had bets, and they ain't settled yet if he was real or just pretend. He told us stories, and they came out his eyes, and he taught us a song. We sang along. You are magic for the magic things, magic dances in the one who sings. You are magic for the magic things, magic dances in the one who sings. You are magic for the magic sounds. Stick your tongue out and let it roll around. You can't help but say la 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 la. Happy all the time. But I met a lot of crazies now. Some of them laugh, and most of them cry. Fuzzy just got old before he grew up. No growing pains to forget. But when you don't do things in the proper order, well, some folks, they get upset. He told us stories, and they came out his eyes. All two, all three of them. And he taught us a song. We sang along. You sing along now, too. You are magic. life dances in the one who sings. Yeah. You are magic, full of magic things. Magic dances in the one who sings. Oh, you are magic, full of magic sounds. Stick your tongues out, let them roll around and around and around and around. La 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 la. Fuzzy. Well, that concludes this week's Wednesday Evening Musicale. Your wonderful requests. I got one coming up next week. I think it's going to be maybe a little more jazzy, bluesy, poemy. Not sure yet, but I have a list of things and I'm going to sit down with them and figure out a program. It's really fun. It's like kind of having raw clay to turn into a musical sculpture at the Wednesday Evening Musicale. I encourage you to visit my website, claudiaschmidt.com. There's a virtual tip vessel there if you care to visit that. I would be greatly grateful. And it's not obligatory, but it helps a lot at this time. You can also look at my CDs that are available. You can see all the past videos are there. If you know people who don't go on Facebook, you can direct them there. They live there now. You can go in the bottom right-hand corner. Sign up on my mailing list if you're not already on it. I also want to mention that on Friday, July 10th, I'm doing a concert at 7 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time that's sponsored by the Folk Project Acoustic Stay Away concert series, adapted from the Acoustic Getaway. And I'm going to be doing like a whole hour-long concert in the spirit of a live concert, the way these all are, because they are. They're alive. We're alive. I'm alive. You're alive. We're alive. Thank you so much for being here tonight. And please share this video. Good night.
Some people can't love from a long, long distance. Some can't love from across the room. Some people jump up in the morning to glimpse the sunrise. Some snap up the shade and let in the bloom. It's a big enough world.